I am not Carla Zeus, but I'll be bringing you Waukee student news. My name is Emily Tobin, reporting live from Waukee High School. Today we have Adina, Lindsay, and Emily bringing you very interesting stories. Adina, we'll go to you now.
I'm Adina Misadanagic, commonly known as Adina Bieber, and I'm reporting to you live from the Waukee Library. On a bright Sunday morning, a woman thought she was faced with the worst thing ever. Her 2-year-old daughter had been cured with HIV. After finding out her baby had HIV, after she was born, doctors went right into curing, 30 hours after she was born. Now the little girl has a chance of a normal life without HIV. Many people think HIV is uncommon, but 30,000 young babies and children got HIV in the year of 2011. Many children, after being in the condition of HIV while they were born, usually have to take one or two drugs. After this baby had HIV, they had to give her 3 drugs as soon as possible. From the worst thing to the happiest, the Mississippi baby got the best news of her life at age 2.
See if you can ID me. I'm a type of vehicle that's been around for more than 100 years. My name comes from a Latin word that refers to a combination of things. In my case, that's an internal combustion engine and an electric motor. Runs on fuel and electricity.
Tobin, reporting to you live from this very beautiful wall at Waukee High School. This next story is on Lance Armstrong, someone who was formerly known as a hero and role model for many. On January 14th, 2013, he admitted to using performance-enhancing drugs, which he had previously denied. His heroic reputation disappeared, and he disappointed more people than he ever thought possible. Stripped of his Olympic and multiple Tour de France awards, Armstrong let down the country as he proved to be a liar and a cheater. As time has gone on, Armstrong still refuses to meet with the United States Anti-Drug Agency, which was encouraged. Some say that Armstrong's confession will lead to more strict rules in the sport that will lead to a new era in the long term. Some say that Armstrong's confession will lead to a more strict rule policy in the sport, and that will lead to a new era. Long story short, don't lie.
I'm Lindsay Motzel reporting live from Waukee. On Thursday, February 28th, Jeffrey Bush, 37, was in his bedroom when the earth opened and took him and everything else in his bedroom into it. Crews planned to begin demolishing the Florida home on Sunday that perched over a huge sinkhole. After coming to conclusion that it was going to be too dangerous to keep searching for the man, the 20-foot wide opening of the sinkhole is almost completely covered by the house, and rescuers feared it would collapse on them. Heavy equipment, including vehicles with bucket scoops on large arms, was on the street near the house Sunday morning. Hillsborough County Administrator Mike Merrill disclosed the plan hours early to raise the home. At this point, it's really not possible to recover the body, Merrill said. Jeremy Bush later stated that a couple months ago, an insurance agent came to routinely inspect the house for sinkholes and other issues and said nothing was wrong. And a couple months later, my brother dies in a sinkhole.
Time for a shout-out extra credit. In which of these areas could you best see the Aurora Borealis? You know what to do. Is it in the Arctic Circle, Amazon Forest, Sahara Desert, or South Pole? Rewind that clock to 3 seconds and go. The Arctic Circle would be an ideal spot to see the Aurora Borealis or Northern Lights. That's your answer, and that's your shout-out extra credit.
I'm back to you live from the Waukee High School. Should marijuana be legal? Iowan's support has slipped a bit for legalizing marijuana for medical purposes. In 2010, 64% of Iowans supported the idea, 6 percentage points more than now. Support remains low for legalizing the drug for recreational use. Only 28% support the idea in 2010, and 29% support it now. Legalizing the use of marijuana for medical purposes in Iowa is 38% opposed and 58% in favor. 4% were really not sure. Legalizing the use of marijuana for recreational purposes in Iowa was 68% opposed and 29% in favor. 3% were still not sure. What do you think about this? See us on our blog. What do you think about this, Justin Bieber? I don't know.
Hi, I'm Emily Erickson. The Obama administration has recently made the decision to repeal the ban on women in combat positions in the military. This will remove the final barrier to a fully inclusive military. Most combat positions will be open to women by May 15, 2013, but the repeal will not take full effect until January of 2016. Although critics say women will not be physically capable of doing these jobs, most Americans agree that females will be as capable as their male counterparts.
On Friday, February 15th, at approximately 2 a.m., Jeremiah Johnson and son Jonathan Johnson fled from police when seen at the Love's gas station in Clive, Iowa. The police chase went on all the way from Clive to Indianola. Police say this all started over a custody battle between Jeremiah and ex-wife April Lozano. Jeremiah and April had a long-distance relationship. When he came back from battle in Afghanistan, that's when he realized April had been suffering from drug abuse and Jeremiah didn't want her taking care of their son. Authorities say that it wasn't was in the boy's best interest to stay with his mother since Jeremiah had been suffering with post-traumatic stress disorder. Now authorities are seeing that show going through the police chase. The chase ended when Jeremiah Johnson rammed a police car going 130 miles per hour. Jeremiah was killed instantly, and Jonathan, who was in the back seat of the car during the entire chase, survived with only minor injuries.
Our next story has to do with a topic very common in schools today, bullying. On January 22, 2013, Matt Gainaway decided to take a stand on the Grinnell Newberry School District for bullying his son and inflicting emotional stress on him. Ethan, the son, was being picked on by another student, but his principal, Jeff Kirby, didn't believe him. After calling Ethan a liar, making him sit in the corner and repeat, "I will not lie," he came home crying hysterically, and his dad decided that it was time to take action. Schools need to keep children safe as part of the anti-bullying movement. Ethan was not kept safe, and the bullying that he endured came from an adult, which is completely wrong. November marked the month that Ethan changed schools to start a new beginning, but the memories still remain as he has a hard time driving down the street of his old school still. Ethan's goal for the future is to help his new friends never be treated the way that he is. You can help too by taking a stand against bullying.
The story is about Governor Branstad's education reform plan. It's encountering trouble in the Iowa Senate. Many are skeptical over a proposed program that would add a seal to a high school graduate's diploma. Students would receive a seal showing that they are ready for a career or college. No seal would imply a student was not yet ready for either option. The program would cost $4 million annually, and many Iowans worry that the inclusion of the seal would devalue the diploma and discourage students who did not receive one. Many senators disagree with this part of Governor Branstad's plan for education reform.
Now, we've given you a lot to think about with all these stories we've shared, but now I want to know what you think. So you can tweet at us or Facebook us and tell us about how awesome we are and how much better we are than Carla Zeus.